Insulin, what school staff need to know. Glucose, or sugar, is an essential source of energy for our bodies, and most of it comes from the foods we eat. Insulin is a hormone that allows our body's cells to turn glucose into energy. A healthy pancreas constantly releases insulin to keep blood sugar levels in a healthy range. Food, activity, illness, and stress all affect how much insulin we need. Students with type 1 diabetes cannot produce any insulin. Without it, glucose builds up in the blood, causing fatigue, frequent peeing, extreme thirst, and weight loss. If high blood sugar isn't treated, a person can become very sick. The ideal time to give insulin is before every meal, including lunchtime. Insulin is given either by injection or through a pump. Students on injections usually use an insulin pen at school. The pen has a fine needle attached at the tip, a cartridge of insulin, and a dial that allows the user to select the dose. Some children who are on injections receive a slower-acting insulin at breakfast, which works around lunchtime and in the afternoon. Since the insulin dose is matched to the student's planned lunch and snacks, it is very important that they eat all their food on time. An insulin pump provides a slow, continuous flow of insulin through a small tube inserted under the skin. This is called basal insulin. When a student eats or needs to lower their blood sugar, they need to get extra insulin through the pump. This is called a bolus. The user controls how much bolus insulin the pump gives. It does not work on its own. If a student needs insulin during the school day, whether by injection or through their pump, details will be given in their care plan. Staff who supervise or help with a student's insulin will be trained on how to administer it. After insulin is given, the dose and time should be recorded in the student's logbook or other home school communication tool. Knowing how and when to administer insulin can help keep kids with type 1 diabetes safe at school.